there's a little bit of temptation, confirmation bias, which happens within the human, but it can also happen organizationally, where an analyst discovers some beautiful insight, and then they fall in love with that thing. And there's a lot of temptation to go and find and prove that this is not a red herring. Maybe you should actually move it to someone who doesn't have an interest in proving that that conclusion holds. Someone who's a little bit more independent. One of the easiest cultural quick fixes for data science excellence that everyone should be making, and I don't know why I still have to in 2020 talk about this, but there we go. It's a very 20th century problem. In the 20th century, there was not that much data to go around, usually. A tiny little bit of data. And so what every data science professional learns, and hopefully remembers, is that a data point can be used for inspiration or for rigor, but not both. So you can't use the same data point to ask a question and then answer it rigorously. Not when there's uncertainty. Not allowed. So the quick fix, the trick, is if the problem is that you've got one data set and you're being forced to choose between inspiration, good questions with no answers, or rigor, but perhaps a good answer to the wrong question, you're forced to choose between that. The quick fix, if you've got lots of data, is take that data set, split it into two data sets, hand one to the analysts, hand the other to the statisticians. So leave the one that is for statistics, leave it hidden in escrow, essentially. No one's allowed to touch it until a decision maker has looked at these potential insights that analysts have brought them and said, ah, these are worth opening our secret stash of data for. Because then you've got a question that is that fits the patterns in this data set. And if you want to trust that these patterns exist also outside this data set, then you had better come and show that it still holds up outside that data set. Same principle in machine learning. Testing is very important. You should never test your machine learning system on the same data that it learned from. You must always give it a fresh data set for testing. And so there's a lot of good sense in putting statisticians somewhere outside of the group that has an incentive to launch a machine learning system. So you've got the statisticians checking that the machine learning system also is worth launching. You've got them checking the analyst insights. You might have decision makers, stakeholders at various levels in the organization delegating decision making, but also having some data stashed and some statistical team where they can check whether or not there's some little bit of wool being pulled over their eyes, because, you know, there's some strategic persuasion that happens with data. We understand this, even though we might not love it.